Okay, so it says that it has now created the dashboard panel. So let's take a look. So if we go here in test cursor, we see that we have the render walk with time series. That was the original one, and this is the new one which we have said the duplicate. So it create the duplicate as well, same exact duplicate. The graph looks different because it's a time series based on a random event, so it will never be the same. But this is pretty cool that you can do all of this using cursor AI, and this is where you are getting the complete AI observability via Grafana. Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're gonna learn how to use the Grafana MCP server with Docker. It will be a step-by-step instruction how to install it, configure it, and make use the Grafana MCP server to talk to your AI agent such as Cursor and interact with Grafana UI to create dashboards, panels, and so on. So let's get started. A short intro about myself. So my name is Usman and I work in Grafana Labs as a staff developer advocate, and I have been with the tech industry for more than 15 years, and I love using Linux and like to use open source tools. So if you are someone who are new or experienced user and want to learn these tools, you can check my YouTube channel where I have created some content, and also I write a blog post and documentation which you can also find in every video in their description. So let's get started for today's video. What is MCP server? So in very short, MCP stands for Model Context Protocol. It's basically an open protocol where it provides an interface to interact with the LLM tools such as Claude, Cursor, ChatGPT, and so on. It is totally free to use, and it provides custom integrations as well. And it is very helpful for developers and engineers to automate tasks. Similarly, Grafana has its own MCP server. So this is what we're gonna learn today. So how to use the Grafana MCP server with Docker. Here lists some of the advantages of using the Grafana MCP server. And I think the very first one is the most important one, that is getting the AI-based observability. So you can get complete observability in an automated way via AI. And this can help and reduce a lot of your work. It is also open source, so you can use almost on any operating system. And it provides many built-in features such as for dashboard, it can list dashboards, create dashboards, and for data sources, it can list the data sources, even do the query for some of the data sources which it supports, and also provide administrative tasks for admin users. You can also use to create some alerts in Grafana, and it is integratable in many AI tools such as Cursor, Claude, and so on. So these are the minimum system requirements which you need to have. So for the operating system, you can use either Windows, Linux, or macOS. For softwares, you need to have Docker, Grafana, and Cursor available. You can use Claude as well. In my case, I'm using Cursor because I'm running it on Linux, but it doesn't matter. It is very easy to configure it. And for the hardware, you need to have at least two CPU cores available and at least 1 GB of RAM, only for the MCP server, not as a complete, and 10 GB of disk space if required. And for the ports, you need to have port 3000 enabled for Grafana and port 8000 for the MCP server. Also, I have write this article where I have explained the MCP server and the Grafana in detail and all the system requirements. And also it provides some step-by-step instruction. Since the video is always very detailed, so I can't write everything there. It's nearly impossible. So that is why it's best to follow the article and also the video together so that you can get it easily done. So let's start with the demo. So what we're gonna do today is that, as mentioned, that you need to have Grafana installed. So I have already installed Grafana via Docker, and I'm running it via Docker as well. So on Grafana, we will first create a service account token. So what you will do is that if you are new to Grafana or don't use it, so just click on user and access. go to the service account and create add service account, and let's name it cursor, okay, and change the role from viewer to admin and click create. Okay, now your service account is created, but we need the token as well. So what we're gonna do is that we will click this button which says add service account token, and give it a name. Again, we give it cursor. Okay, and we can set it to expiry or not expiry, it's up to you, and click generate token. And this is the token, so copy it to a clipboard, maybe save it to a file or editor, it's up to you. It's a temporary for now, but we're gonna use it later on. So this is the first step which you have done. Now the next step will be to configure this token into the cursor tool. So I have my cursor up and running, and I will just close everything. Okay, so what you're gonna do is that click on file, click on preferences, and click on cursor settings. Now it will open this window, and somewhere here you have to find the tools and integration section or the tab. Click there, and here you will find some existing or non-existing integration. For us, we want to integrate the Grafana MCP server, so click on the new MCP server and you will see this file. So it might be blank for you, but since I have already configured it, so it's already defined, but I have wrote this file details in my article. You can find from there. Basically what we are doing is that this is all predefined since we are using Docker, so this is all predefined. We don't need to change anything. What we only need to change is the IP address of the Grafana URL. So defined, if you are running on a different IP, just change this part, the port remains the same, and then you copy paste the Grafana API key. So basically the key, the token which you just created, you simply copy it and paste here. Since again mine is predefined, so this is all good. And now what we're gonna do is that we have done this, and we will open the chat terminal in the cursor, and we have already selected the mcp.json. so now let's try to test it out. So let's write list all the dashboards. So before I write this command or instruction here, I just want to show you that I have these three dashboards in my Grafana server, okay, or Grafana UI. And now let's write this list all the dashboards. And you can see now that we give this instruction list all the dashboard, and we have three dashboard, and the cursor AI give us all the information with the name of the dashboard. The first one is the new dashboard, the second is the random walk with gauge, and the third is the test cursor. And it also provides the dashboard ID, even the UID and the URL. So this is pretty cool. Now what we will try to do is that we will try to tell the cursor to create a duplicate panel for the dashboard name as test cursor. Let's try it out. So I just write the instruction that create a duplicate panel inside the test cursor dashboard and name that panel as duplicate, so that we know like it has the same name what we have defined here. So let's press enter and let's wait for that. Okay, so it may ask you to run this tool, which is fine. I haven't allowed it to do everything automatically, So it asks me for instructions. It's again the thing that how much control you want to give to your AI tool. I like to keep some control for myself. So yeah. Okay, so it says that it has now created the dashboard panel. So let's take a look. So if we go here in test cursor, we see that we have the random walk with time series. That was the original one. And this is the new one, which we have said the duplicate. So it create the duplicate as well. Same exact duplicate. The graph looks different because it's a time series based on a random event. So it will never be the same. But this is pretty cool that you can do all of this using cursor AI. And this is where you are getting the complete AI observability via Grafana. So I really hope that you have learned a lot from this video, that how to use Grafana MCP server and integrate with cursors to get the AI observability. And it's pretty cool. Ask your questions, feedback, and suggestions in the comments. And also don't forget to check the link in the video description for all the documentation and the link to the article where it defines all the instructions. So I hope to see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.